Across every nation, across every culture, special occasions mark our journey through the year. These events, full of laughs and fond memories, serve as festive reminders of our values and our shared principles. And then, the sun disappears and the air becomes dreary. It is at this season, as the torch is passing from old to new, that the most important of values is taught, for it alone can alleviate the harsh winter and keep the earth warm through the bitterest season. If, when winter comes, you are counting your packages, assessing their retail price, then you've forgotten the treasure of self-sacrifice. Remember this always, that although through gifts our love we show, generosity is not made by sums of dough. Christmas stays with us in the way we live, reminding us all what it means to give. Now here's a man whom most could guess lives a busy life and enjoys much success. But as the fog of winter came and brought him his gold, alone sat his wife, left in the cold. She prayed for him always, as a good partner should, and clung to him as long as she could. But his partners brought wealth, and to her he would say, "Holidays are scarcely ever so gay. Christmas is business, and business isn't free. Those moms and dads pay a high price, and so must we." And one year, for Thanksgiving and Christmas straight, he left for his office in spite of his mate. Forgetting about her and the care they once shared, he left and took everything, not a single penny spared. Now on the streets, she wished and she warred for the things of Christmas which she could not afford. As the winter months fell and their sad truth to show, tears froze on her face as she sobbed in the snow. Christmas brings joy, you think that it should, and to those who are cold, you'd think that it would. Joy then seems brittle if it's bought in a store, meant only for those who are blessed to have more. And it happened one eve when she received a large sum, that she leaped away thinking, "Christmas has come." But while counting her bills, she caught herself stumbling, then stopped by a man who apologized, "Sorry, my bungling." Then telling from the rate that the stranger was hustling, she felt to ask, "Good sir, what's troubling?" "A baby is coming, I'm bowed out of time. I was sent to buy blankets, but I'm worth less than a dime." To this man, who warred against cold, she realized warm milk was equal as gold. Although telling herself something she could ill afford, down in her spirit was struck a deep chord. So, giving him everything, her Christmas she shared, leaving herself not a single penny spared. Oh, if only his joy the tramp could express, you never would tell he had faced such distress. But if she, whom he owed a large debt, what more from Christmas could she possibly get, when she had more life than food in her tummy, and joy surpassing the sum of her money? Following him to a building, drafty and old, there was the woman, lying in the cold. Awaiting in earnest, the minutes went by, then suddenly the room filled with new infants' cry. And from their happiness, the parents could barely speak of this miracle that happened when things had seemed bleak. But for she, whomever Christmas had given, she didn't need gifts or the holiday's traditions. It was here, while standing in snow, that at last the true meaning did show. Too long for Christmas she fought, but there she had found it, in the blankets her money had bought, protecting a new baby boy, and warming hearts with unspeakable joy. So let's learn from this, the meaning of love. It's when from your possession you give something of. It makes Christmas more than gifts by a tree. It's whatever one does to bring another glee.